My name is Rajiv Sridharan. Welcome to CNC Learning. In this video, you will learn all that you wanted to know about threading. Threading types, thread parameters, G76 cycle, and much more.
Let us begin with a threading animation. Let us look at some of the thread definitions. This is called major diameter, the highest diameter of that part is an extended thread, and this is called minor diameter. And major dia is only considered as thread size. Let's examine an enlarged view of a thread. This is called angle of thread, this or this. Pitch is the distance between two threads. In inch system, it is designated as threads per inch. That means how many number of threads in 1 inch. So you can derive pitch by using a formula, pitch equal to 1 divided by threads per inch. And this is called pitch diameter. This is the diameter where the distance between the flanks in horizontal direction becomes pitch divided by 2. Some more definitions. Root of the thread. This is the root. Flank. These are the flanks. Crest is the crest of the thread. Now pitch diameter, we have already seen that is the effective diameter of the screw thread. Approximately it will be halfway between the major and minor diameter, and the condition we have already seen. So this is the pitch diameter. Helix angle. We'll see what is the helix angle. So this is the helix angle. So if you unwind one thread, so it will look like this. And based on minor diameter, pitch diameter, and major diameter, you will get different helix angles. So for calculating the helix of one thread, we need to consider the pitch diameter, that is the effective diameter. And the formula for calculation is tan inverse, number of starts multiplied by pitch, that means the lead. If the thread is single start, this will be equal to pitch only. Lead and pitch is same. Divided by pi d. And this d2 is pitch diameter. So you can see when this is unwound, for calculation of helix angle, this is a pitch, and when this is unwound, it will become a form like this, a right angle triangle. This is our helix angle, so tan theta of this will become p by pi d. So eventually we will get the helix angle. Now let's see some of the threat types and applications. Isometric and American UN, that is having a threat angle of 60 degree, that is used for general purpose. Whitworth, British Standard, American National, Pipe Thread, NPT and all. These things are used for pipe threads. And Whitworth, British Standard and all will have an angle of 55 degree, and American National, NPT and all will have 60 degree. Round DIN 405, that is used for food and fire, 30 degree. MJ-UNJ, that is used for aerospace applications, 60 degree. APA rounded, APA buttress, all these things are used for oil and gas. So angle you can see, both side different angles, and there is another taper also. Trapezoidal, ACME, stack ACME, that is used for motion like lead screw and all. Trapezoidal is 30 degree and ACME is in general 29 degree. Now let's see types of threading inserts. There are two varieties. One is full profile, so it will look something like this. Here you can see, along with cutting the thread profile, it is cutting the major diameter for external thread and minor diameter for internal thread. And another variety is V profile, that will only cut the thread, not the crest of the thread. So the advantage of using full profile is that it will maintain the thread depth. So you can see, since the insert is cutting both the root and the crest, so you will get a complete thread and there won't be any burr. But on the other hand, the advantage with V profile insert is that you can have less inventory. The same inserts, you can do multiple variety of threads with the same angle, whereas full profile, it is limited to only one type of pitch or TPI. How the threading insert is named, nomenclature. So this, again, there are different varieties. So this, I have taken reference of ISCAR cutting tools. Some other cutting tool manufacturer, you may find some differences. So since most of the cases you will find a nomenclature like this, we are going to discuss this. So one insert is 16ERM1.5 ISO. So the first one is for insert size. This is the insert size. So diameter of this inscribed circle, 16 is 3/8 inch. Next is application, external, internal, U-type external, U-type internal, U-type external and internal. So regular type inserts will look like this and U-type will look like this. Third is hand of the tool, R for right hand, L for left hand, RL for right and left hand. So here 16 is size of the insert, E is for external, R for right hand. Now, fourth one is the type of chip former and all. So here M mean it is pressed to size with a chip former. Otherwise it will be ground or no indication. Fifth one is the pitch or TPA. So for full profile insert, this value is the pitch or TPI directly, or if it is a partial profile, it will be denoted by a letter, or sometime it will be directly the V angle. So here you can see A is 0.5 to 1.5, AG is 0.5 to 3, like that different ranges. So if there is a letter, that means it is a range. And the last one is the thread standard. Whether now in this case it is ISO, you may find UN, VSP, Round, ACME, UNJ, like that. So whichever thread form is required, accordingly you have to select. These are the different types of thread infeed method. So while cutting the thread, how the insert is fed into the workpiece? Depth of cut, how the depth of cut is given? Modified flange infeed. So in this method, mainly you can see on one side the cut is very much limited, the other side only majorly the cut is being taken. So the advantage of using this is that the cutting load will be less. So most of the cycles, controller cycles, you will find this method. Another one is radial infeed, which is very simple to do program and all. So it is directly each depth of cut is just given directly on radial. Here both side the insert will be cutting. Advantage is that the wear on both side of the insert will happen, but the disadvantage is that there will be more load because the surface contact will be more. Next one is incremental infeed. So this is actually a better version of modified flange infeed. In this, what benefit we will have is the insert will cut on both sides so that you will get more tool life and even tool life. Threads are of two different types, right hand and left hand. So how the hand of the thread is decided? It is decided by the spindle rotation and direction of cut. Now how the spindle direction is decided? It is based on the hand of the tool. So if your tool is a right hand tool, then the spindle direction will be different. If it is left hand tool, spindle direction will be different.
The threading hand depends on the spindle rotation and the cutting tool direction. Now let's see, if the spindle is rotating counterclockwise and the tool is moving inside, so the thread form would be like this. That means a left hand thread. Now let's assume the spindle rotation is counterclockwise and the tool movement is inside to outside. So the movement will be like this. So the thread will be a right hand thread. Now let's assume that spindle rotation is clockwise and the tool is moving inside. Clockwise and inside. So the hand is right hand. Now let's see the other case, fourth case. Spindle is rotating clockwise and the tool is moving outside, inside to outside. So let's see. So now you can see the thread is left hand.
So this is the most common method. So here you will get a right hand thread. A right hand tool is used. So if you are having a front turret machine, then this is the form you are using. The tool will be placed like this and the spindle rotation will be like this. And the tool direction is like this. If you are using a back turret machine, then you can see the insert is turned down and the rotation will remain same because it is based on the insert positionally the rotation is dependent. Now you can see if the insert is like this, the rotation has to be like this. So same way the on the rear turret insert has to be like this. And a left hand thread, if you are using a left hand threading tool on a rear turret machine, this will be placed like this, insert up, and on a front turret machine the insert will be placed down and spindle rotation is like this. There are different ways to cut right hand and left hand thread. So here you can see a right hand tool with the insert up is held on a rear turret, whereas on a front turret with the insert down. So here in this case, obviously the spindle rotation has to be like this, and to make a right hand thread the tool direction has to be like this, inside out in both cases. Now to make a left hand thread, if you are using a left hand tool on a front turret machine, then the insert has to be up, the spindle direction will be like this, and the tool direction has to be inside out. On a rear turret machine the insert has to be down, spindle direction will remain same, and the tool direction is inside out. Now let's see an Indiana thread, right hand tool. The spindle direction is like this, so insert is down and the cutting direction is outside to inside. Same way to do a left hand thread, a left hand tool with insert up and tool direction outside to inside, and according to the insert position the rotation is like this. Another way of doing right hand thread, this will be on a front turret machine, a right hand tool. So this will produce a right hand thread outside to inside and the spindle direction like this. And the same method, if you put the tool with insert down, then the spindle direction will become like this and the tool outside to inside. Now a left hand tool, to make a right hand thread, insert up, spindle direction like this, and the tool direction inside to outside. electron thread, same arrangement with insert down. Tool will move from inside to outside and the spindle direction is like this. A right hand tool. Now a left hand tool with insert down, spindle direction is like this and tool direction is inside to outside. And a right hand tool, spindle direction is like this, tool direction is inside to outside. You will get a left hand thread. Now let's see the G76 cycle. This is the most complicated cycle. There are many parameters. So let's see one by one. A thread profile is shown and the way in which the cycle is run. For each pass, there is a calculation used for calculating the depth of cut. So initial cut will be more and then gradually it will reduce. And the finally, where the depth of cut has to be locked for minimum depth of cut, that we need to define in the cycle. And there is a template available to make G76 cycle. You can freely download in the website cnc-learning.com. So how the thread happens? Wherever the tool is positioned, from there it will come down, and if there is any taper defined, it will go in a taper fashion and then lift in a chamfering fashion if that is defined. So there is, each parameter is defined like that. You can see first line, let us see G76 P M R A. There are three parameters in one P. M is the number of spring passes or idle pass in the last, after doing all roughing, this is the repetition of cycle. And R is the chamfering amount. That means after finishing the thread, at the end of the thread, if there is any angle required, any chamfering amount required, that means from the depth of the thread, it will lift in a angular fashion. So that length 5 mm, 10 mm, like that you can define if required. It can be 0 also. And the third one is the angle of the thread, this angle. Then Q delta D min. So this is the minimum depth of cut. So with this calculation, it is going to be from the first depth of cut, it will gradually reduce and sometime it may go very less. So we can lock that depth of cut with this amount so that whatever be the calculation, the depth of cut will not go less than this amount. And this is the finishing allowance. So whatever value you want to keep for your final cut. In the second line, X and Z endpoint. So here you can see this is the X and this is the Z. So this is the thread endpoint. So in case of a external thread, X will be the minor diameter. Z is the thread endpoint. From there only this chamfering amount will be back calculated. Then R is for the taper. I, you can see this value. So this is your final X. From this it is calculated. So keeping this value constant, the start point is only changed. And K is the total thread depth. Here you can see, and Q is the first depth of cut. Here you can see. First depth of cut can be more because the surface contact will be less, and as it goes down, the surface contact will be more and cutting load will be more. And the last parameter is feed rate, and feed rate is equal to the lead. If the thread is a single start thread, lead and pitch will be same. If it is a 3-start thread, pitch multiplied by 3 will give you the lead. Now let's see how thread height is calculated. The example shown is metric and unified threads. Okay, so on the thread, there is one right angle triangle formed. This is the half of the pitch. This is the height of thread, total height, theoretical. You can see the actual thread cone, if you take, this is the start point and this is the end point. Okay, but the actual thread will have a, it will not be sharp, there will be some flat or radius. So now we are going to find out this theoretical total height and the actual thread depth. So this is the theoretical height of the thread. This is the thread angle, half angle. So if you consider this right angle triangle, now tan 30 is opposite side by adjacent side, that is P by 2 by H. So P by 2, from this equation you will get the height of theoretical height of the thread. P by 2 tan 30. The value will be 0.866 multiplied by pitch. Now the actual thread height required on the part because of the shape, because it is not going to the full theoretical depth, some rounding will be there or some flat will be there. So considering that the actual thread depth is this much, and as per standard, the maximum thread height is defined as 6/8 of theoretical height. So 6/8 multiplied by theoretical height. So if we multiplied the value of H, we have already found out here 0.866P. If we substitute that, we will get 6/8 multiplied by 0.866P. So the calculation will become 0.65P. So whenever you are doing a metric and unified threads, the thread height or thread depth, what you need to calculate is 0.65 multiplied by pitch. This one. Accordingly, we will see the thread heights for various threads. Isometric, American UN 0.65P, Whitworth, VSP, NPT, MJ, UNJ, all these things are 0.65P. Trapezoidal and ACME will have only 0.5P. Now we will see an example for thread cutting cycle. . 68 is a major diameter. Minor diameter can be calculated as 60.2, or it may be given in the table. You can directly use it. 6 mm is the pitch, 105 mm is the total thread length, so an enlarged view of the thread is shown here. This is the first depth of cut, total depth. So this is how the cycle is defined. Now let's see each one. First, the tool is positioned at X75Z5. So this is our zero defined, and 68 is the part diameter. So safely we can position the tool at X75, and this face is Z0, so 5 mm away, and then G76 cycle. So the first parameter P, we have already seen that will contain three information. What is that? First one is how many number of spring passes or idle passes, and the next two digit is for chamfering amount, or it's also called runout, thread runout. This is what it is. So after the thread, it will be slightly lifted like this. And third parameter is 60 degree. That means thread angle is 60 degree. Next one is the final X. For an external thread, it is minor diameter. So you can see this one, 60.2, and Z is final X, final Z, Z minus 105, you can see 105 here, and P is 3900. Here you can see the total thread depth is calculated as 3.9 mm. How we have got? We already seen that metric or unified thread will have 0.65P. So here pitch is 6 mm, 0.65 into 6 will give you 3.9 mm. So here you can find it is not 3.9, it is 3900. So you have to multiply by 1000. Why we have to do it? Because the value is in microns. R we have not defined, we can even ignore it. There is no taper in this, so R is ignored. This is the total thread height, P3900. Next one is Q1800. So this is the first depth of cut. 1.8 mm is the first depth of cut given for this. So multiplied by 1000 will give you Q1800. Next is F6. F is the feed rate equal to the lead or pitch. So for single start, lead and pitch is going to be same. If it is multi-start, you need to take lead. And what are these two things? We have already discussed. This is again a micron value, 0.1 mm. This is a minimum depth of cut. So with this calculation, the depth of cut is going to be decreased for every pass. So finally, it should not become less than this value. That is what it means. It's a minimum depth of cut. And R50 is again micron, 50 micron or 0.5 mm would be the finishing pass left. So there is a small finishing pass kept. So I will repeat once again, tool is positioned safely at X75Z5. Then there are two lines of G76. First line, there are three parameters P, Q and R. P will have three components. First one is for number of spring passes. Second one is for chamfering amount at the end. And third one is thread angle. Q100, that is for minimum depth of cut. R50, that is for final finishing allowance. And next line, X and Z are the final X and Z coordinates. R, where you want taper, you have to define R. In this case, it is 0, you can even omit. P3900 is the total thread height, 3.9 mm. That is calculated by 0.65P here. It is mentioned in microns, so whatever value is the thread height, you need to multiply by 1000. The next one is first depth of cut. So here in case it is 1.8 mm multiplied by 1800, and the last parameter is feed rate, which is equal to the lead or pitch for single start threads. So this is what the G76 cycle is. So we'll see a thread cycle again. First pass. Now you have already seen that when your tool is like this and the direction is like this, you will get a left hand thread. Next pass. And nth pass, mean last pass. So your thread is ready.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have liked it, press like. Subscribe the channel for more such videos. Click the bell icon for getting notified on new videos. I will come with more videos like this. Bye for now.